at the AFWA Sutherland Children's Park. We're here for one reason, and it's to talk about landlord-tenant issues. It's the Landlord-Tenant Forum organized by Property Express, and they are the organizers for the Ghana Property Awards. Now, very soon, we're going to take you in there to the panel to discuss rental issues, property issues. We're going to have the general public here to ask questions, to ask the panel questions on any concerns with regards to the rental market. Come with me.
To discuss rental issues and property issues. So at this point, I just want to invite the panel to come and take their post so we can commence. Thank you. Right, okay. Before they come, we're just going to take a very quick prayer. So, Mr. Samuel Mante, can you come and give us a prayer, please?
Hello, please, can we pray? Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this morning. We thank you, Lord, for all the things you've done for us.
Even that everything that we are here
to be a successful program. Pray for with our and for this to your hands. We also pray for those on their way here and believing that everything will be well with you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.
Okay, so on the panel today, we have representatives from the Rent Control. I've got Mr. Nafis Idrisu. A round of applause for him, please. Thank you. Mr. Nicolas Sewanu is also a manager for Rent Control. And then we have from the National Tenants Association, Mr. Frederick Opoku. Panel, the CEO from Property Express, Ghana Property Awards, Mr. Robert Wege. Oh, come on, you can do better. Another round of applause. Right. Okay, so this is an open forum. At some point, we're going to invite you with your questions, any questions that you do have with regards to renting. How many people are renting in here? Can you just show me by hand? Okay, thank you. And how many people are landlords in the audience? Yay! Okay.
Rent control is there. Covering all rental premises in Ghana, and we are under Ministry of Works and Housing, Water Resource, Works and Housing.
Okay, so that's what you do. So what are the general feedbacks that
what do you do on the
basis? When you come into contact with a tenant, for example, what's the typical scenario that you have to deal with?
What we do is that we educate on cases, all rental cases. That is what we do. And some of the complaints come, you understand? Some of the complaints that come are inducing tenant to quit, you understand? Nuisance, recovery of possession, and then rent arrears, and all, so many cases. So we adjudicate on that.
Okay. I'm just going to ask Mr. Idrisu, what should one consider before signing an agreement?
Okay, thank you. Before a tenant would sign an agreement with a landlord, the tenants would have expressed interest in a room or perhaps a premises that the landlord owns. So some of the things they would have to agree on is the issue of rent. We call it recoverable rent. That is the monthly rent that is payable by a tenant. So once this is agreed on, then the land decides on the number of years advance. So when this is also, you know, agreed on, then the obligations of both the tenants and the landlord. After this, the facilities that are supposed to be part of what the tenant is renting. So after all this is agreed on, then they put it into a document, which we refer to as the tenancy agreement document or statement of tenancy agreement. So when this is documented, both parties would have to sign. Then there should also be a witness who equally signed, and that becomes binding on both parties.
Okay, just a personal question really here. For example, I have a family member who rented a property out to someone, okay? Now, this person is in this property, and this person gave the property out to somebody else. Okay, and the person left a candle burning in the property and to the extent where the property was burnt because of that. I mean, who do we hold responsible? Can we take this person up legally?
Exactly. Thank you very much. You see, if you are a tenant, before you sublet the premises to another person, you must seek the consent of the landlord. So when it is done, the landlord would be aware of the first person. But in the scenario you've cited, it's like the tenant sublet the property to another person without the knowledge of the landlord, which constitutes an offense. So when the new tenant, normally we call them self-tenant, okay, but if he moves into the room and becomes a principal tenant, any action or act by him that leads to, you know, the burning, you know, with the example you've cited, where a candle is lighted, which finally results in burning of the premises. In such situations, definitely you can take a legal action, if only you can prove that what the tenant done was deliberate. Okay, but if it's not something deliberate, I think these are issues that can be tackled at the court.
So if it's not deliberate, it means this person goes away scot-free. Is that what you're saying?
Not necessarily, you understand. But these are legal issues, and there are some technicalities that would have to be taken into consideration.
Wow, wow, wow. Mr. Poco, I can see that you are agreeing there. You are nodding in agreement. Okay, can I just ask you, is it necessary to be a member of the tenant association? What are some of the fringe benefits that comes with that?
Yes, first of all, I think I should thank you for giving us the opportunity to appear in this program.
Oh, thank him. That's the CEO.
Actually, for Tenant Association of Ghana, we thought that certain institutions have been there for a long period of time because of the issue or the fracas between the landlord and tenant. Many a time, you could see tenants being frustrated, being exploited in so many ways. And when they to go to a rent control, they don't get the refuge. Maybe go into detail. But the question you ask me, I want to clarify that point. Now, to be part of the Tenant Association of Ghana is a very large body nationwide who are coming together to fight for the rights of the tenants, let them know the legal education, what it's supposed to do. Not that we are going to fight against the landlord. Meanwhile, tenants also have certain rights and responsibilities that they must honor whenever they occupy a particular premises. But many a time, you realize that some of the tenants are violating issues that they are not even aware that is even if contradict the law that can even allow the landlord to get rid of the person. So we think that it's good as a tenant to be educated about this issue, one. And that we as tenants coming together to fight for our rights. So if one tenant has a problem, it's a problem, collective problem of all the people, not one person. We also believe that if you are an individual and you have a problem with a tenant, a landlord rather, and you want to forge ahead, fight for that right. Many a time, as I said, if you go to birth control, a lot of issues, people, they are corrupt in courts. Which, of course, yes, Tumbo has many times refused that. But there are certain things that we can see that many a time they are being exploited. And that we want to serve as a middle rule between the tenant and the rent control. You understand? Legality wise, we have lawyers that we are putting in place. If we go and we are not too happy about the adjudication of the rent control, we pursue to court because the Act 220, yes, give us the right to do so.
Okay, I'll come back to you again, but I just need Mr. Idrisu to answer or respond to the allegation of the rent control being corrupt.
I think the issue of corruption is a national problem or canker, as they normally say. But you see, once you allege that officers are corrupt, you see, it remains an allegation. But not until you are able to provide evidence. That makes the work easy. So if you keep on alleging without providing evidence, how then do we take such people on? That is the issue. But another thing I must point out is the fact that rent control is not just there for tenants. Okay. The Rent Act of 1963, Act 230, spells out various provisions and sections. And it caters for both the interests of the tenant and the landlord. So you as a tenant lodging a complaint at the rent control department does not necessarily mean that the determination or decision of the rent manager at the end of the day should be in your favor. So decisions that are taken would be based on the facts of the matter, weighing it against what the Act says.
Okay, Mr. Opoku, what are some of the reoccurring challenges that tenants draw to your attention as an association?
First of all, I would want to make it clear that there's a lot of challenges, and the one that obviously you can see, which reoccur, many a time happen to be an issue of people not able to pay their rent. When it's due, one, people also are forcibly evicted because maybe a landlord says that my family member is coming from where God knows, and that you are giving me a month or so to relocate without even considering whether to compensate them, because according to the Act, you know, indeed, I make reference and quote that even if you intend to do that, whenever maybe you have a family lodging at a particular point in time, you must give an ample time to the person. And even if the person does not agree to that, he can pursue it at the court of law. Because maybe the time you tell that the family is coming, maybe he doesn't have anywhere to go. And many a time, you see landlord pushing that in a way. Sometimes, if a tenant is not able to pay the rent, then he begins to find ways and means to say that this is a problem, this is an issue, and that. You know, that. So one challenge happened to me, people not able to pay their rent when it's due. But the law says that you can't evict somebody from the premises if he is not able to go by the rent. But the law also says that even if he's not able to pay the rent, there's some time that you must give to the person. Because even on human rights basis, logically, you can't just say that you can't go to go tomorrow. So it shouldn't be less than 3 months. And the rent people are here for this to impact. But many a time, okay, many a time.
Okay, Mr. Sowan, you want to say something here?
I think I want to add something to the issue of rent control being corrupt. See, renter issues are very technical. You understand? It's very, very technical. And we work with the Rent Act. We have the obligations of the tenant. And then we have the obligations of the landlord. We have certain things, the offenses. And they are all in the Rent Act. And so sometimes what happens is that when the tenants, they lodge the complaint, or landlords lodge the complaint, and then they don't know the Rent Act, you understand very well, and then they lodge the issue, and at the end of the day, the issue goes against them, and they will say that rent control is corrupt, you understand, but anytime you come into that conclusion, it doesn't make the work easy, very, very easy for us. It looks as if we are not doing anything.
Okay. I mean, I know the rent control is actually lobbying for a bill to be passed, which is very positive. Can you just enlighten us on that? Can you elaborate on that?
Yes. There are so many acts which, or the laws in the Rent Act, which are outmoded, and they are crying out for a review. For instance, the issue of rent advance, 2 years rent advance. What the law says, that the Rent Act says, that you shouldn't take more than 6 months. But what are we seeing? We see landlords taking more than 2 months, 2 years, 3 years, and so on and so forth. The problem is that it's with the issue of demand and supply. You understand? For instance, now the demand, we have housing deficit in Ghana. We have about 2.5 million housing deficit. And the demand is more than supply. If demand is more than supply, obviously about 10 people will be fighting for one house, one room. You understand? And so because of this, there is limited thing we can do about it. We can do much about it. What we can do is that after you've taken occupation, and then you pay for the 2 years. But then the 2 years expires, and then you are not able to pay another 2 years, and the landlord demands for 2 years
because you are not able to pay, he says that, okay, eject, or I'll eject you, or evacuate from the premises. When it comes to us, we make sure that we put the landlord in the right position.
I'm just going to speak to Mr. Webe very quickly. So you deal with the up market as well, you know, as far as properties goes and renting goes. I just want to find out this issue about dollarization and also goodwill. I mean, where does that come into the equation as far as, you know, the Ghanaian market is concerned?
Well, thank you very much for your question. When you talk about dollarization, what happens is that you realize that the market has been already said demand and supply are happening very high. And most of the developers or tenants actually buy some of their products in dollars.